It's amazing when the lights go out, somebody grabs a microphone, people get quiet. It never happens that way in church. Maybe we'll turn out the lights when I preach. Well, I believe, yeah. Hillcrest has been in lay-by and snore upon the first day of the week. And when I start preaching, that's kind of what happens. We're glad everybody is here tonight. This is a pretty special night in a lot of different ways, and we'll kind of talk about that as we go along. But before we get into the real heavy-duty reason for being here, and that's the entertainment, I want to turn it over to Ken Hoppe for just a moment, president of Crowley's Ridge College. I've got a big hand for Mr. Ken.
I want to welcome everyone to this event tonight. It's indeed a special night. It's a special night, as Gary has said, 25th anniversary of a very special event that has raised a lot of money through the years. And this year is going to be no exception by looking at the crowd here tonight. Fitting to be a representing night as far as raising money for CRC. We're so appreciative for this event. We're so appreciative for the women from Crowley's Ridge College. And over the years, more than $400,000 they have raised and then done projects on the campus. It's just amazing what a group of ladies can do when put them together. I'd like to take just a moment for our WCRC ladies to stand, if you will. Stand and put your hand in there, if you will. Stand up, WCRC ladies, and a whole bunch of them. We've asked the WCRC ladies tonight if we can make a special presentation just because we have a large crowd here tonight. And this is a school presentation. And I need Richard Hare, Richard Johnson, got the wrong name. I need you to escort Miss Virginia Harris up here. Oh, really? Miss Virginia Harris is an employee here at CRC, and she has been for several years now. And will you tell us how old you are? She's 90 years old in August, and she works here at CRC. You can tell we're slave drivers. That's CRC. A few years ago, Miss Harris came our way, and she is our sandwich lady. She prepares sandwiches. We have a sandwich line in the cafeteria. And the sandwich line is a very popular line among our students. But tonight we've got a plaque that we want to give her because we have a yearbook here at CRC. It's called the CRC, it's the Heritage Yearbook. And our student body and our students involved with that yearbook make a dedication each year of that yearbook. And this year they're dedicating the yearbook to Miss Virginia Harris. And so we want you to give her a round of applause. I just want to read part of this tonight. She has become very special to our students. Our students are the ones that selected her. It wasn't faculty and staff, it was the students. She needs to understand that and realize that. That this is a student honor. She needs to be very proud of that. But it says, ever since a friend told her about a job opening at CRC, she's been the sandwich lady in the lunchroom. She's prepared by nature, whether it was bottled milk back in her many days ago, for delivery or currently a handful of roast beef on white bread, or simply each day's beginning when she wakes up singing and welcoming the day. No matter the circumstances, she declares a beautiful morning. That's her approach to life. And we have seen that in Miss Virginia Harris, and her students have seen it, Miss Virginia Harris. And she's meant so much to our students. And thank you for this award tonight. Special things about this night that we can do, and we're so appreciative for that. At this time, we'd like to pause for a moment of prayer for this evening. And we knew Larry Bills, our former CRC president, who was president here from 1987 to 2001. We asked him if he wouldn't mind to lead our prayer for us tonight as we begin this wonderful evening together.
Before we pray, let me express our thanks, Sarah and I, and our daughter Amanda, who is with us tonight, to express our thanks to you for your support of Crowley's Ridge College, and particularly for this occasion, for the women of Crowley's Ridge College that sponsors it. We're so appreciative of all the good work that
they do, and your support of them. That's all thanks. Father, there are more things to be thankful for than we could ever accomplish in our lifetime. And one of those things is Christian people, Christian friends, and particularly on this occasion, Christian education in places like Crowley's Ridge College. We thank you so much for the vision that established it and those that have sustained it through these years. We thank you for this occasion, for its sponsorship by the women of Crowley's Ridge College, and for the occasion of enjoyment and an uplifting evening that we will provide by the entertainment. We thank you for the food that we have enjoyed so much. Help us to always recognize that it's your gift to us. Let us never forget that. And let us remember all of these things in the name of the greatest gift of all time, the gift of your Son, Jesus, who died for our sins. It's his name that we pray. There's all kind of things that happen on the stage that y'all don't need to hear and all that, but we have a lot of fun anyway. As you can see on your program, next up, we're going to have our national anthem. Now, I was asked 2 or 3 times, who's going to sing the national anthem? And I said, a couple, 3 years ago, we sang it congregationally. And let me tell you, I really, really appreciate that. Larry, are you going to fling it on the wall? I know we have a flag right there. There it is. Upon command, we get a flag. If you don't mind, stand with me. Let's sing our national anthem. And I'm going to get us started. And we're going to continue on together.
Oh, say can you see?
We want to thank both of them for their time and for sharing their talents. WCRC efforts at a dinner theater first began on March 6, 1992. It was entitled Dinner at Dog Patch and was directed by Becky Woolley. But by the next year, the first hee-haw type show was created and entitled Barnyard Bash. Kathy Rowe was the musical director that year and has for 25 years been instrumental in so much of the behind-the-scenes work to put on this show. Kathy, would you please stand? Barnyard Bash would not happen without the band. Is that not right? The band has been the most talented group of women I have ever seen. We're so thankful to Gary Cummings. He loans so much of his equipment. He sets it up, he gets the music together, he gets the people organized, and he gets them all together. We're especially thank Steve Goins. He's the one that wrote the Barnyard Bash song that we enjoy every year. He took time to do that. It's great. Kevin King, our public, Barry Joyner, Damon Green Johnson, and Kim Lovely is helping us tonight. So many people have come and gone and helped. This band says that they have played for 25 years, and they plan to play another 25 years for the Barnyard Bash. That some of the singers that come pick out a song to sing, and the band has never played it before, that they can listen to a CD just one time, sometimes two, pick out the chords, and do an excellent job as backup for the singers, and we appreciate them so much. Thank you to the band.
It's kind of like some of the jokes we tell. We tell them they had never heard them. There's some more folks behind the scenes that we want to talk about and thank tonight. Bill Pangburn and Lance Johns. I'll get it out here in a minute. These guys are going to put the seats out and put some tables out. If you didn't have them here tonight, you'd be on the floor right now. So they thank you for that. Larry Johnson, he's back here in the back somewhere. He's doing the video and all that stuff. He's kind of our Barnyard Bash geek. Take care of all that stuff. Then you got the secretaries that take care of making up all the programs that you see on your tables, and they handle all the ticket sales. If it wasn't for them, y'all wouldn't be here tonight at all. So we need to thank them for that. But our tent tonight, yeah, go ahead. Our tent tonight is to take a 25-year walk down memory lane. And hopefully you'll recognize and see some folks that were a lot younger when this all started. But we want you to be able to see those folks and appreciate the efforts that they put out. And it's a fact. Faces may change, but the bash is going to be back. So sit back, enjoy the show, and we hope you enjoy it.
Folks, says, hey, let me say this real quick before we get into the theme song. Judy, I think I already had them turned off, Scott.
There's one more turn off.
21
maybe?
It was my fault.
Now I've got it turned off. If it wasn't for Judy Lambert, Miss Lulu over here, I don't know how in the world these folks had ever come up with anything to say. She labors long and hard to put together funny things, and she trolls the internet, and she looks all over the place trying to find good ideas, and I'm telling you, she has come up with some of the best, most, man, knee-slapping comedy, and you're going to get to see a little bit of that as the night goes on. How about a big hand for Miss Judy Lambert? Said all that. How about a big hand for Mr. Steve Goins?
Down to the barnyard.
And not only that, he's not in all that great a mood. The place where he was staying burned last night. The fire department said they'd never seen a station wagon plane that high. Oh, thank you very much. Oh, we got a young man coming up here. If I could be as tall as him, I wouldn't be as short as I am. How about a big hand for Mr. Tyler Killow? I'll let him introduce his help.
This is important.
We got Miss Aubrey Marshall and Mr. Chandler Cup.
What we are and grow.
is what we learn when we young. You may wander from the fold, but like father, like son, like you a man. When I was a child, he was so calm, and I was so wild. But I always wished that I could be that way. Now I find I'm growing a little calmer every day. Like father, like son, like mother, like daughter. What a song.
Walked off again, and
Next time Junior came through, that man stood right up in his face and he said, "Maybe you don't know who I am, but I am a Princeton grad, a Rhodes Scholar, a U.S. Senator, and I'm running for President of these United States." Junior looked him right in the eye and said, "Maybe you don't know who I am. I'm the guy in charge of the butter." Well, recently I learned the difference between a rooster, a president, and an old maid. The rooster says, "Cock-a-doodle-doo." The president says, "Yankee-doodle." And an old maid says, "Any-doodle-doo." Oh, boy. Well, y'all know that for 25 years, I've been trying to find me a feller to live through these golden years with, you know. I thought I'd found someone, but he's depressed, and now he doesn't want to go out. Well, he's depressed. I know you're wondering why he's depressed. It's because he lost his job down at the factory. I know you're wondering why he lost his job. Grandpa, chime in there anytime.
Why did he lose his job?
Oh, he lost his job over something that was said.
What was said?
You're fired. Oh, boy. Thank you there for the help. No. He came to me then, and he said, "Minnie Pearl, I'm a little short on money, and I was wondering if I could borrow some." I said, "Now, Elroy, you haven't paid back the $100 that you borrowed from me last week. But I'm feeling generous, and so I'll tell you what. I'll just forget half of it." He said, "Minnie, would you do that for me?" I said, "Yeah, I will." He said, "Well, I'll tell you what. I'm just going to meet you halfway, and I'll forget the other half." I said, "Elroy, you know, there's some work around here, probably at CRC, that you could do, sweeping up and washing windows and stuff. You know, you work, you make a little money, you put some aside, and then sooner or later, you don't have to work." He looked at me and said, "Well, Minnie, I ain't working now." Oh, boy. Grandpa, he said he's had bad luck too, you know. He was dating Rowena, but they broke up. They broke up the other night when he was at her house and they were making chocolate chip cookies. And he remembers it well because it was his job to peel the M&Ms. Well, they got into it, you know, and they had words, only Grandpa didn't get to use any of his words. When he met Rowena, she was working down at the travel agency. He was looking for a vacation, and she was the last resort. Oh, boy. He asked Rowena, he said, "Would you like to go out with me sometime?" And she said, "Oh, no thanks. I'm not looking to go out with any particular guy right now." He said, "Well, you're in luck, because I'm not particular." Found out real quick, though, that she had missed her calling. She should have been an earthquake predictor because she could find a fault quicker than anybody. I thought I found another old fella recently. He was from Poland, but I found out real quick that he was paranoid. He was always thinking I was out to do him in. He went through my purse, and he said, "You're trying to kill me." And I said, "I wasn't." And he said, "Yeah, you are. Look what I found in your purse." And he pulled it out. It was a bottle. "See, it says Polish remover." And I tell you what. I had a date, though, last weekend, and I was afraid it was not going to be a good one, you know, a little boring. And so I asked Lulu if she would call me 30 minutes within the date, you know, and tell me that Grandma was sick. And so sure enough, it was not going well. And so Lulu called me and said, Grandma's sick. So I told him, I said, I'm sorry, I have to leave. Grandma's sick. Big smile came on his face and he said, oh, that's all right. In a few more minutes, my dog was going to get ran over. Well, that's my luck. Well, you know, all this reminiscing about the last 25 years has got me to thinking about how poor we were when we grew up. We were just poor, you know.
Burglars. How poor were you?
Well, we were so poor that burglars broke into our house and left us money. Oh boy, we had a garden though, and that kind of got us through some things, but one summer, we grew 10 rows of corn and 10 rows of tomatoes, but oh, we tried to plant some seedless watermelon, but we couldn't find any seed. Oh, that was a dry summer though, I'm telling you, it was dry.
How dry was it?
Well, it was so dry that I saw two dogs fighting over a tree. And the Baptists were sprinkling, and the Methodists were just using a sponge. Oh, boy. One day we were working in the field. I was working with my daddy, and here came the preacher. He was walking down the road, and he said, are you working in the vineyard? Daddy said, no, I'm working in my corn. And he said, well, are you a Christian? And he said, no, I'm a Jones. Sam Christian lives up the road 2 miles. He said, well, are you ready for the resurrection? Daddy said, well, when is it? And he said, well, could be today, could be tomorrow, could be the next day. And Daddy said, well, would you do me a favor and don't tell my wife? We don't get out much, and she'll want to go all 3 days. Oh, boy. I'll tell you, I guess I'm about finished here. Read my paper and all. You know, there's some really good singers coming up, but there's one feller that I haven't heard of, but I heard that they found him on the internet, on eHarmony.
Attention to the screen.
you just saw, is not a little gal anymore. She's grown up and she's married. She's going to come up and sing that very song. How about a big hand for Miss Aubrey Beth Marshall?
Riding on the sea of New Orleans, Our street looks like a cemetery. And our trash can got blown down to the Wilson's house. They think they've got two trash cans.
Well, I'm just leaving it down there. Anybody knows that with a plastic trash can, you can't burn no trash in a plastic trash can. Everybody knows that. At least I do now.
Hey, do you know what day this is?
Yeah, let's see. It's been about a year ago today that you got that mud pack stuff to put on your face. You know something, Lulu? You look pretty good for a couple of days. And then that mud fell off.
I think you would remember. Today is the 25th anniversary of Lulu's Diner. Can you believe we have been here for 25 years? Silver anniversary. I decorated the table in a little aluminum foil for a little festive.
25 years. Man, how many more years are you going to make people sick?
I've been trying to tell you, Junior, I've made a huge decision. Huge decision. Look at that map right there.
Okay. Pick it up and look at it. It's a map of Florida.
It is a map of Florida. And look right there at that town.
Lulu, Florida. Lulu, Florida? Man, that's got to be a big old town.
There really is a Lulu for you. And when I found that out, I thought, that town has got to fit me. That is the best town. I bet I could venture there in the winter time, and I just think that would be a perfect fit for me. And so I'm going to make a commercial and sit down there. I contacted the Lulu Chamber of Commerce, and I'm going to see the commercial down there.
A commercial? Are you going to open up a business down there?
Maybe just part-time. Don't you remember that 25 years ago, before I opened the diner, I had a small business where I went in people's homes and I helped them learn how to do home entertainment. Remember that?
Yeah.
I did that before we opened the diner. So I thought if I sent a commercial down there, I might could do that part-time down there.
Sounds like a good idea.
So have you got the video camera? If you get the video camera going,
all right, it's good.
Then I might can.
All right, let's see if we can get that red light to pop on back here. All right, there's the red light. Right back there, everybody. Right there. I think I'll get you to look. There's the red light. All right, are you ready?
Okay.
3, 2, 1, go.
Hello, my name is Vivi, and I am a consultation specialist for hometown and home entertainment. I want you to know that I have a business, and it is called get the sign. Would you hurry up and get the sign? It is called Lulu's Porta Potty. Party. Porta Party. Porta Party. For only $19.95, I can come to your home and explain to you exactly how you do it. You can. Just come to your home and explain to you exactly how to entertain in your home with no trouble and no fuss. I know why people don't entertain anymore. It is because it is too much trouble to clean up your house and run outside to the kitchen and back in and outside to the kitchen and back in. It is just too much trouble. And this is good news where you can entertain right from your dining table. For those of us who are aerobically impaired, yes, sir. We're going to entertain, cook, and everything right from one table. All you have to do is dig out a path from the front door to the dining table. All you need is one plug-in, and I will show you how to do it. For just $19.95, I can come to your home and teach you every bit. Let me give you just a little sample. I would assume that every person in this room, every person that's watching this video would have one of these. You probably think the only reason you would have one is to iron your clothes, but let me suggest that there is several ways that you can use this iron in cooking right from your table. It makes beautiful, delicious sandwiches. You just wrap your sandwich in whatever stuff you have in your sandwich, the best cheese, the best ham, whatever you want. Wrap your sandwich in foil, put it on the table, and let it cook. You can entertain and talk and visit. Flip that sandwich over, and it can cook some more. Let me show you exactly what it looks like. Doesn't that look appetizing? And if you don't want to eat it, the kids can play with it. I hope you enjoy that, sir. There's lots of things that you can cook with iron. There's not just sandwiches. If you want to have a better, you know, a higher class meal, I really enjoy cooking lamb chops with this. You just wrap your lamb chops up again in foil. Now, it takes a little bit longer, but you can just put your iron on there, visit all you want to right there at the table, flip it over, cook and cook and cook. Not just limited to that. You can have steamed vegetables or pressed ham. Now, on that sandwich, you want to put your iron on, that permanent press. But on those lamb chops, you want to put it over on the wool set. Now, I bet most of the women watching this video have one of these. And you probably thought that this was only to style and curl your hair. I should wash that thing. But may I suggest, it's a perfect cooking tool for you in your house, at your home. Just put it on high curl. Now, there's several things you can cook with this, but I really enjoy the little cocktail weenies. If you'll just put the cocktail weenie right on your brush. You can cook several at a time. And for a festive look, you can use your little party toothpicks. Now put this on high curl, and before you know it, they're just a sizzling. Now, there is one drawback to this. Let me give you a little disclaimer. Usually when these start sizzling, the juices run down and just short this thing out. I shorted out five of them, but I'll work. There is one thing that you can do. If you take your little toilet paper and put it right there and stick that thing right down in there, it catches all the juice. Now, it had a lovely centerpiece on your table. Now, I would think that a lot, if you've got the curling brush, you've probably got the curlers. Should have washed that thing. Now, there's several things. What I do is I take the curlers out and I leave the hot rods. You turn this on high curl and you get this hot and let the rods get real hot. Now, there's several things you can lay in here and cook for your dining table, but the thing I like the best is these rolls. Let me show you. After you put them in there and close it up, put it on high curl for just a few minutes, you can take that out. Let me show you. It leaves a little hole. You'll see that. That's perfect for jelly, butter, honey, or whatever. But what I like to do is take my little cocktail weenie. And then I take my little toothpick. And there you have it, a hors d'oeuvre. So be sure and contact Lulu's Porter Party. And for $19.95, I can come to your home.
Hey, Lulu. 25 years I've been getting the hair out of every place you ever had. What happened? For 25 years, I've been getting the hair out of every plate that you've ever made. And I'm all starting to understand everything going on.
Now, I hope you'll turn your attention to this.
I'm back.
on, and we bring the folks that were in that video. Now, the thing you're going to find out is Kelsey has changed the most from that video, as you're going to see in just a minute. How about a big hand for Angie and Haley and Cody? Join them. I knew Cody would appreciate that a great deal.
That was kind of bad to put that before me there. I almost cried. I did tear up, but I'm okay. Did you cry? Y'all ready to go? She got a vocal music scholarship, and she's there her senior year. And Sunday is her junior recital. She changed her major, but she had her senior recital last year and her junior recital this year. But anyway, she's doing about 3 or 4 different languages in an hour program in opera. So she couldn't be here tonight because she was preparing for that. So you guys can pray for her for me to get through the weekend for that. But she's okay. She cut her eye. And anyway, she's going to be okay, but just a little stressed. So just remember her in your prayers, please.
She'd have been here tonight if it hadn't been for that. And several other things that are going on this weekend. How about a big hand for Cody Joyner? You know, he wouldn't come out from under the porch till he's 14 years old, and now we just can't hardly get him to quit. You'd sing something off the top of your head. How about a big hand for one of the tallest guitar pickers I've ever known, Mr. Barry Jones?
She's from my dear sweet wife who has a birthday today. Happy birthday, dear. I'll not say how old she is.
Yeah, you've done enough this week.
Yeah, I did enough this week.
You need to tell the story about the guitar.
About 4 years ago, we were listening to this song, and my wife said, "Why doesn't your guitar sound like that?" I said, "Well, I was playing a Telecaster like Steve." I said, "Well, it's got different pickups." I said, "I need a guitar that's got humbucker pickups in it to get that sound." And she said, "Well, do you think you could build one like that? Because I build guitars." And she said, I said, "Well, yeah, I could." Well, she said, "Boy, I'd really like to have a guitar that sounded like that." And I ordered this kit the next day. So this song is the reason I got this guitar 4 years ago. I promised to sing this song on this stage. I'm just not getting around to it. But anyway, here you go, better or worse. For you, baby. Don't forget that, it's for you. You're going to get me out of doghouse.
Music. All right. Before we begin this half, Pam Cox, who is the vice president of WCRC, she's one of the vice presidents of WCRC. She has an announcement that she wants to make regarding an upcoming event, and this is a new event. And so we want to turn it over to Pam for just a minute. Scott, you're ready to go.
On your tables, you'll see flyers. All right, we have a new fundraiser that's going to be the Pioneer Trail Run out here on campus. This is going to be May 6th, it's the Friday night. We're going to do a 6 p.m. run. This will be a 2-mile run that'll loop around campus, and it's done as a fundraiser. Two things. You can sign up and run, which I would love for all of you to do.
Go.
Or we need sponsors. So if you would like to be a personal sponsor, come talk to me. Or if your business would like to be a sponsor, we'll put your name or your logo on the back of the shirt. The shirts will actually look pretty similar to the top of this. But take these flyers, hang them up around town, and I've got lots more if you need them.
Dad, you plan on getting in on that? Where'd my dad go? There he is. Dad, you gonna do the 2-mile run? You gonna do the 2-mile run? If the bathroom is down the end, you'll probably do that. All right, as we begin this second half, and we did this 2 years ago, and those of you who have gone to the oldest show at the Collins, you've seen this before. One of the best piano players I've ever seen in my life, we are very privileged to have here tonight, Mr. Ken Wadley. Give him a big hand. Now, what Ken does, he will take requests from the audience. You can holler out a song, and I'll bring a mic and get in the general vicinity. I'm deaf in one ear, and I don't see good out the other. And so we can try to hear it. We'll get how many songs you want us to get. All right, we're going to look at 8-10 songs. They can be all different kinds of things. And let me tell you, the first one needs to be Music Box Dancer. Now, what he is going to do, you're going to give him a song title, and we're going to do about, we got Last Date. I've already heard that. Wipeout? That's always an exciting song on the piano. Oh, by the way, his sidekick, good friend Casey Bandy, is going to be playing drums with him as he does this. Which is pretty interesting because he has all these transition things that he does. So we got Music Box Dancer, we've got Wipeout, we got Last Day. I heard that. We got In the Mood. Now what was that? How Great They Are. The William Tell Overture. I don't know that I've ever been in where you've ever been asked to play that one. It is a new one. It's actually not a new song. All right. Great Balls of Fire. The man can do that. I know he can do it. Kiss an Angel Good Morning. I heard that. And what else? The Razorback Fight Song. That's a different. Don, did you ask for that? Why am I not surprised? Leader of the Pack. Freebird. How many is that? That's several songs. One more. Rhinestone Cowboy. I heard that. Now, if we didn't get your song, come back next year. Maybe he'll be back and maybe he'll do this again. I don't know. But at any rate, prepare to be amazed and astonished. How about a big hand for Mr. Ken Wadley? Yes, he does.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Jim Lovely and Casey Dandy. And I gotta be honest with you, the one I'm most impressed with out of that was the Razorback Pike song. I wouldn't have known you to know that.
Are you a fan?
Well, there you go. Pretty amazing. He's got more licks than a herd of puppies. Well, that's a good question. Stevie is struggling with his voice, and we're trying to see if we got one we can coax out of him, but we don't know yet. He'll know here in just about half a second. You don't think it's going to be better to go on? Let me say something real quick about the band. We're going to skip the song that Steve would have sung, but Buddy, if he'd have sung it, it'd been really, really good. He'd been doing this. Have you been doing the Bash ever since it began? I know 1 year you got sick, and Chad Garrett at the last minute filled in and played guitar. And Barry played, has been playing a number of years, but Steve's been at this a long, long time. How about a big hand for Mr. Steve Goins?
You know, a while ago on the video when Dad was singing, you asked me how Dad was.
When he was singing that song on that video, yeah.
I think, if I'm right, when the video was made, Dad was the same age that I am right now. That's scary.
You were quite a bit younger at that time, I noticed. Yeah. Thinner. That could be said of a bunch of us. But anyway, down on the far end, one of the tallest guitar players around and one of the nicest guys you'll ever meet, Mr. Barry Joyner. Back here on the drums, he has done sound, he has played drums, he has played sound and done drums. He's done it all, and he's done it all at the same time when he had to. I've got a big hand for Mr. Kevin King. And as you've already seen, this is the second time you've played the Bash with us. An incredible talent, to say the least. I've had a big hand once again for Mr. Kevin King. My son, who's the last, well, since Kevin has started playing drums because Skeeter Nash moved off. I played drums once or twice a few years ago and then started playing bass. But when Skeeter Nash moved off, because we utilized him while he was in town, we got Kevin off sound and put him on the drums, which means we need somebody to run sound. And my son, Scott, has done a wonderful job with that. Scott, please. Now, as I said, Steve's voice is not going to allow him to do the song. So we've got a lady, and I hope to goodness she knows she's next, because I don't know where she's at. Oh, good. She knows where she's at. She is going to come and sing a Loretta Lynn song. How about a big hand for Miss Haney Reed?
Do a little better if I talk for a minute.
Okay.
I'm going to do this for my mama and my daddy, and my son is here, and I have about three girls that I went to college with drove over to hear me tonight, so I'm going to do it for them. We were poor, but we had
suffering and enduring.
Because the main thing is my great philosophy of life. This philosophy has got me through many situations in life, And that filioficy is
that's right.
Of many. What's filioficy?
I don't know.
Oh, well, anyway, that the filioficy is eat one live toad the first thing in the morning, and nothing worse will happen to you the rest of the day.
That's right. That's right. Yeah.
And Grandpa Jones would be the better person for this office because he's older and got more experience than the junior here. And if for some reason the job required him to go to Washington, D.C., that'd be okay with Grandpa. But Junior, he wouldn't want to go to Washington, D.C.
Oh, no, he wouldn't do that. That's way up there in the Morgan.
That's right. That's right. Hey, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now, it sounds to me, and I'm speaking on behalf of Grandpa Jones, my brother, it sounds to me like you're gathering up all the meat just for Lulu's diner.
That's right.
Yeah, and not for the whole county to enjoy.
Now, Junior, how do you answer that rebuttal?
Well, if you froze all the meat in the cooler at Steph's mortuary, we could possibly have enough meat collected by next year to furnish the entire Barnyard Bash barbecue.
Junior,
that's right.
How do you answer that rebuttal?
Hunting our own meat is the right thing to do, and I'm just so happy.
Just what is it that you think you're planning to hunt? That's just what I thought, frogs. Junior, you know that we can't serve frog legs more than 2-3 times, and the customers get tired of frog legs.
Did you hear that? Flying over the store right now.
What's flying?
There's a flock of ducks flying over the store right now.
What?
Be quiet. Shh.
You look just like you on the phone.
Yeah.
control pills and Valium all mixed up.
Oh, yes. What happened there?
Well, she had 14 kids.
Yeah.
And she didn't care.
That's bad. Now, I understand that he was working in this hospital. He had been in his emergency room for 22 hours, and we haven't seen a doctor yet.
Now, this is getting kind of ridiculous. I'll tell you what, why don't we go ahead and take Grandpa's temperature? Because it just so happens I've got my trusty thermometer for breakfast. And what is take Grandpa's temperature? Here we go, Grandpa.
There is no telling when that ice can fit that. Where's that button? Don't they have one of those tall buttons where you can get somebody to come and help you out?
Yeah, now here it is.
Now here it is. I'll do it.
Of our landings.
Okay.
Buddy,
I can't hear you. if a good wind comes along and that thing flies up, you get caught up in a tree, you'll look like a monkey hanging there. Don't you want to take it off?
Oh, I guess I can take it off. It's a little bit wet on the bottom anyway. Just a few minutes ago, I accidentally let it drop in the toilet. Oh, I guess I can let it drop off a little bit. All right.
Well, come on, let's go, because we'll see if Grandpa's got that float gas stuff.
Yeah, well, Junior's always gas stuff if you get my drift.
Name.
Christian lady that said, I had never heard her sing before last night. Justin said, this gal can really sing, but she's never sung with a live band before. And we don't think after she got finished, she'd sing with a live band then. But anyway, she sang with us. She does a really good job. How about a big hand for Miss Mallory Brown?
These comedians have you saw the props that they've had throughout the years, and they've always paid for their own props. They've never asked reimbursement from WCRC. They've always bought tickets to the shows and bought their families tickets to come and see them. So we wanted to give them something else too, and we have a card with a gift certificate in it.
Once again, let's give these comedians a big hand. I said, if you get the idea that just because they're retiring, that it's going to stop, and we're planning on going on next year, we're going to revamp a little bit. We don't know what it's going to look like, but come back next year, bring 50 of your favorite friends, and we'll all sit together then, won't we? This next guy coming up, you've probably seen him in a video a while ago with hair. Dark, nice, very pretty hair. For whatever reason, he's decided to get rid of that. Now he's got the Mr. Clean look. How about a big hand for Mr. Royce McMillan?
Hello, everybody.
Says, hey, Doc, I can remember when you couldn't stop and fly. Oh, but ain't that America for you and me? Ain't that America something to see, baby? Ain't that America home of the free? Yeah, the pink houses for you and me. Oh, yeah, for you and me.
For you.
Certain you buy things from the country store that are half price, because otherwise my wife's going to take it home. I'm diabetic. I can't have them anyway. So anyway, buy things. Folks, we are glad that y'all came out tonight. We're going to close this show tonight. And as I said, we're planning about this time next year to do this again. It'll maybe look a little different. It'll be some other folks that'll be involved in the thing. But regardless, we're going to be here next year. But I can't think of a better guy to close out the things with than this young man who is probably, he sings about as well as Ken Watley plays. That's a pretty good trick if you can do that. How about a big hand for Mr. Chad Garrett? Come back, baby, this next year. Remember, if you drive it, make sure you got a car. You'll